Hello student, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastek channel. Welcome back. So we are in module 3 of MP and MC of 17 CS 44 of UTU syllabus. In that we have already completed the portion related to signed number operations. Now the second topic is string and table operation. So string and table operation. So we will see for the string we are using data segment and extra segment. Other than that, we use SI and DI, and we use CLD and STD. You will come to know all these things. First one, what are the string instruction? String instruction is, so in the exam, they will ask you to write at least 3 to 4 string instruction, or they may ask any one of the instruction to explain. So for example, move string byte. So what is the source? Source is a data segment. Destination is a extra segment. When you use a data segment, you use offset SI. When you use extra segment in string, you use offset DI. You have seen this in a palindrome program, right? In palindrome program, while copying from one segment to the other segment, we are using offset SI and DI. Move string word. Similarly, here it is a word. Here word movement, source and destination. Store string byte, it will store string byte, source is from register and destination is extra segment. Store string word, source is register and destination is extra segment. Then load string byte, load from memory to AL, load from memory to AX word. Compare string byte, compare both string, here both strings are there, compare. With this you can use prefix also, repeat equal, repeat not equal. This you have seen in a palindrome program. At the end of the palindrome program, you can see, you will compare string byte till it is equal or not equal. Then compare string word, then scan string byte. So source is AL and destination is this one, scan string word. All these are different types of string instruction. From exam point of view, these 5 string instruction, byte and words, are important. Now what is the prefix you can use here? Repeat, repeat 0, repeat not equal 0. So you have to remember, when repeat means condition for exit is, it will repeat till CX becomes 0. Repeat equal or repeat 0. Till 0 flag becomes 0 or CX is 0, repeat not equal 0 and repeat not 0, till 0 flag is 1 or CX 0, this condition repeats. Now you will see, write a program to copy 20 bytes of data from one area to the other area. So this is the area, this is the first location, see here, this is the first location, all of you please concentrate, this is the first location, data 1, and this is 20 bytes are there here. That you have to copy to data 2. Data 2 is not initialized. 20 characters are locations are reserved here, you can see. So first is initialization. Initialization of the 2 segments I will do, because I want both data segment and extra segments. Then clear direction flag. So when you use clear direction flag, you know this is the advantage of this instruction. Both SI and DI will move to auto increment mode. When you use clear direction flag 0, both will go to auto increment mode. When clear direction flag is 1, clear direction CLD, this will make direction flag is equal to 0. When direction flag is 0, both register will go to auto increment mode. When one more instruction is there, STD, set direction flag, STD means it will set the direction flag to 1. That time both register will, SI and D will go to auto decrement mode. So here now you move the address of the data 1 to SI, address of the data 2 to DI. Then move CX, 20, means I want to copy 20 times. Then move byte from one area to the other area, repeat till CX becomes 0. till cx becomes a 0. Please remember here, your counter will take 10, not 20, because at a time you are taking two characters. That's why at a time you will take two characters. So counter is 10 and repeat move SB till counter becomes a 0. So this will copy from this data from one area to the other area. So now write a program to store AAH in 100 memory location. Use the load S to test the content of each location to see AAH is there. If test fails, then display bad memory. What is the meaning of that one? What is the meaning of this one? Meaning of this one is I will use a string instruction to copy A in 100 location. After that, I will check whether A is copied or not properly by using load. I will try to load from AA from memory, and I will compare that with the AA. If it is not matching, means it is not stored properly in the memory, there is a bad memory, something like that message I have to display. So we will see this one. So here, first step is initialization of the data segment. It is explained already. Clear direction flag. What I am doing here? I will make direction flag is equal to 0. What is the use of this one? By making this one, you can increment SI and DI automatically without using INC statement. So first, move the offset area of memory where you want to copy AA to DI, and copy AA to AX. Since we are copying 4 numbers of A at a time, counter is reduced to 50. But in the problem statement, copy AA 100 times. But here we are copying 4 numbers of A at a time by using 16-bit register, counter is reduced to 50. And repeat this one, STOSW. Repeat until CX becomes a 0. This will store AA in the memory. This will repeat each time. D will get incremented automatically. This goes to next memory location and it will store AA. It goes next memory location until counter becomes 0. This will repeat. Once this is done, now you have to see whether things are stored properly or not. That's why now you move the offset address of the memory to SI. This time you use SI and use the counter 0. This time also you can use CX50, but what we are doing is we are comparing AA. We are taking each memory location and comparing AA 8-bit. That's why I am using counter 100 this time. So load SB. This will load the content from the memory to AL. What is the content? AA. And then compare that with AH. Initially AH is loaded with the AA. You know AH contains anyway AA. So it will compare that one. Jump no 0. If it is not 0, if it is not equal, then there is an error. You have to display the message. Jump no 0 over. You have to display the message. Error. Otherwise, repeat this one till it completes. Once it is done, exit here. So this is the way you will copy this one to memory. Now, next program, assuming that there is a spelling mistake in Europe, in this electronic dictionary, and user types in something like EUOROPE, write a program that compares two and displays the following message depending on the result. If they are equal, display the spelling is correct. If they are not equal, display wrong spelling. So first one is you see, according to dictionary, this is a Europe. Then whatever user typed, this is the one. Then the two message, when the spelling is correct, wrong spelling. CLD, direction flag is zero. That means auto increment of SI and DI. First point SI to this one, dictionary. Then DI to data typed. Then use the counter 06. 06 counter is used here. So you can see there are 6 characters are there. So 06 counters are used here. Compare the byte. Take each character and compare. Jump equal over. Jump equal over. Display the message. Spelling is correct. Otherwise, jump not equal. Display the message. Spelling is wrong. So this is a very simple program to check whether the two strings are equal or not. So in the exam they may ask two strings are equal or not. You can check like this only. Write a program that scans the name and replace the G with the letter J and then displays the corrected name. So here you can see in this one, one location contains the name. Here we have to replace G with the J. So for that, initialization of the for string operation, initialization of the both segments are required. Clear direction flag, you make direction flag is 0, that will auto increment and decrement DI and SI register. Then move the offset of data 1 to DI. Take the counter 09 because 09 characters I am taking here. Then move AL comma G. This character G you move to AL and repeat till not equal scan byte. Repeat till not equal. Repeat the scanning if not equal. Repeat the scanning. You scan 1111 character till not equal. Each time it will take, first it will take M, it is not equal. Increment D high, move to the next R, it is not equal. Then next dot, it is not equal. Next space, not equal. Next G, equal. Repeat this one, equal. Till not equal, this one. If it is equal, then it will come out. If it is equal, it will come out. If it is equal, it will come out. If it is equal, it will come out. If it is not equal, over. If it is equal, it will come out. And you have to decrement DI. For example, why you have to decrement DI? Each time while comparing, you will increment. So for example, suppose you are here. So just think like, so this to avoid confusion, here DI is here. Next character, when you increment DI, it will point here. It will point to the next character. So each time you increment DI. So when this becomes equal, then you have to replace this character. And your pointer is here. So you have to decrement one step back, decrement DI, and replace that character with the J and come out from the program. For that purpose, we are using decrement DI. So let me repeat once again here to avoid the confusion. See, first DI is equal to this one. DI is pointing here. DI is this one. And it will scan. So it is not equal. Then DI moves here. Not equal. DI moves here. Not equal. DI moves here. Not equal. DI moves here. Equal. Now you have to, your pointer is somewhere here now. You have to come back one stage and replace this character. That's why decrement DI and replace that character with the J. Xlat, very important question. Xlat. Xlat is nothing but translate instruction. Assume that you are using a table for the value of x square, like square of 0 to 9 numbers are there, 0, 1, 2, 1, 0 square is 0, 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, 9, 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16, like this table is there. I want to map the number to the table. Suppose I want to get the square of 2, 4. That time you can map it by using xlat instruction. But only one condition is you have to use one register, BX register, that should have the offset of the table, that should have hold the offset address of the table. So you can see here, so here in the BX register, offset address of this table is stored, and I will move the value 5 to AL register. I want a square of 5, and I will use the command xlat. When you use the command xlat, immediately what it will do is it will refer the table, and 5 square is 25, it will give the answer 25. So in this way this works. This is xlat. So similarly, you can use xlat to convert a particular code conversion value, code conversion using xlat. So here you can see ASCII value, ASCII table, and XI value and ASCII value. You can use that three table, XI value and ASCII value, and you can get that value by using this one. So next in this one topic is memory and memory interfacing.